The driverless car is here.
Sensors and software allows it to move through the city on its own.
On its own? Really? Well, yes, it does. Finally. I say finally because for years, car companies promised cars that would drive themselves.
We're all set for auto control.
Here's a GM concept car from 70 years ago.
Hands off steering.
But the driverless car kept not happening. Until now. Now, Google has harnessed artificial intelligence to create a car called Waymo, which stands for Way Forward in Mobility. The self-driving car will change our lives. My executive producer, Maxim Lott, went to San Francisco and Phoenix to learn more about it. Here's his report.
It works kind of like Uber. You open the Waymo app, request a ride, and within minutes, a driverless car just shows up. The wheel moves itself like a ghost is driving.
I'm gonna click start ride.
Alex Roy rode with me. He once worked for a driverless car company. We sat in the back. No one needs to sit in the front.
There is nothing more exciting than getting in the back of a Waymo for the first time and then watching the steering wheel just turn itself.
Regulators in San Francisco and Phoenix allow this because Waymo cars can handle all sorts of difficult situations, like this upcoming left turn on a busy road.
There could be oncoming traffic, and you're turning against or into that traffic. And so you've got to time the gap between vehicles.
Correctly weighted for the cars.
I love riding Waymos. They drive mellow, they take side streets. It's a consistently good experience.
Here, the car makes a U-turn. That's tricky too, because cars can come from any direction. And yet,
with millions of miles driven on public roads, they've had zero fatalities.
Zero deaths and zero injuries. How do the cars manage that? With incredibly sophisticated sensors, both at the top and all over the sides of the cars. These sensors constantly shoot out invisible lasers that bounce back and tell the car precisely where things are.
Which allows the Waymo driver to visualize the world around it in milliseconds.
The magic of self-driving cars is not just sensors, but the AI, the artificial intelligence. These cars operate like a human nervous system. Sensors and radar are the eyes and ears. The brain is thousands of algorithms trained by billions of simulated trips. The more robocars drive, the more they learn, and the smarter and safer they get. They're already better than people.
And now,
the big safety problem is people, not robocars. Most Waymo accidents happen when a human driver hit it.
The Waymo driver was stopped at a red light when another driver ran a red light and slammed into them.
I'm an autonomous driving automobile.
Another self-driving car, Cruise, is almost as good as Waymo, but it has had a couple of bigger accidents. As a result,
California is suspending the use of GM's Cruise driverless vehicles, saying they're not safe enough for the public.
When accidents happen, regulators' instinct is always to ban the new idea. Fortunately, California and Arizona regulators exercised unusual restraint. Waymo still operates freely in these two large parts of San Francisco and Phoenix. This increases safety because, as Alex Roy says,
I'm a lot more concerned about the humans driving drunk, which happens every day.
Not just driving drunk. 6,000 of us die every year because we fall asleep while driving. Hundreds die while texting. Driverless cars would save many lives. Still, many people I talk to in San Francisco hate the cars. First responders complained.
They freeze in front of us. It's still a 15 to 30 minute fix waiting for a technician. That's time we don't have when a building's on fire.
The driverless car companies say they'll make adjustments to let first responders move the cars in an emergency.
We've heard that too. But it hasn't happened.
They're not perfect in every possible scenario yet.
What if a hacker gets into Waymo and hacks 1,000 robo-taxis at once to go off the road?
These what-ifs don't make much sense because for every technology that's ever arrived, there was a what-if. The what-ifs played out. What if a Zeppelin was filled with the wrong gas and struck a tower? Well, we know the answer to that. Solutions arrived and everybody moved on.
But some problems will be hard to solve.
They're already jeopardizing public safety.
People fear robots and change. In San Francisco, Some people say self-driving cars are just
bad. I think a car should have a person behind the wheel.
Some activists stop the cars by putting cones on them. Because the car's sensors see the cone as an obstacle, the car just stops.
Until a technician arrives to reset them.
But cones won't disable cars forever. The car companies will fix that.
A robotaxi that stopped because of a cone could also just back up, the cone falls off, and proceed.
Other human problems will be harder to fix. This man attacked a cruise car with a hammer.
You piece of—
Fortunately, not everyone is so negative. Lots of people in San Francisco love driverless cars.
I loved it. It stops people from drinking and driving.
I haven't seen any accidents. I'd love to try one. Matter of fact, one pulled up here was a Jaguar SUV.
I saw that.
And I go, well, I would give that a shot. Absolutely.
It's one of the few things you can do today that makes you feel like people must have felt 100 years ago. First time you saw a light bulb. First time you saw a plane. And then suddenly, it's as if it was always normal.
I hope regulators allow self-driving cars to become the norm everywhere. This technology can save thousands of lives.
It's really important that we not blanket regulate away an industry that's essential for this country to develop.
Right. Still, there is one big worry about driverless vehicles: jobs disappearing. Driverless cars and trucks especially will destroy delivery, taxi driver, and truck driving jobs. In an upcoming video, we'll explain how that actually will turn out to be a good thing for workers. I know that's hard to believe, but it's true. Thanks for watching. If you want to make sure you receive that next video, subscribe and hit the notification bell.